We all know how important it is to have your fence correctly aligned to your blade. The cost of not having your fence aligned to your blade properly could be losing some fingers. I'm personally fond of my fingers, so I like to have my fence aligned properly, and I'm going to show you how to do it. What we're going to do is align our fence to our miter slot. Just like when we align our blade, we also align it to the miter slot. There are a few different ways to check the fence alignment to the miter slot. They're pretty much the same way as you check the blade alignment to the miter slot. So our first step, as it always is to unplug the saw. The first and most accurate way to align your fence to your miter slot is to use your dial indicator. Start with your dial indicator down at the front of the saw and move your fence over till it engages the dial indicator. Put a mark at the first point that you measure it. It doesn't matter where you measure it along the fence as long as it's towards this end, but you want to measure it in the same spot every time after you've made adjustments. Zero the dial indicator. Slide the dial indicator to the back. And once again, mark the point that you measure. As you can see, we're about 26 thousandths of an inch out of alignment. Now, we know that our fence needs to move over towards the blade at this, the far end. So we need to adjust the set screw on this end of the fence locking mechanism so that it's in slightly more and pushes this end of the fence around. Leave your dial indicator where it is, release your fence, and remove it from the fence rails. What we need to adjust our fence here is an Allen key and a small flathead screwdriver. Again, the key to adjusting and aligning your fence is to make small adjustments. If you make it too big, you're just going to go too far. Let's start by winding the screw in by a quarter of a turn. Put the fence back on and move it across to engage the dial gauge and lock the fence. Once again, zero your gauge and make another check. So we're now down to 10 thousandths of an inch. A little more adjustment to do, but a very small amount. And we have to be very, very careful doing this, that we do it in tiny, tiny increments, maybe an eighth or even a 16th of a turn at a time. At 2/1000ths of an inch, we're within tolerance. Tolerance for these sorts of adjustments is generally 3/1000ths of an inch, which is about the same thickness as a piece of paper. Of course, if you don't have a dial indicator, you can do the same measurement with a vernier, just like we showed doing the blade alignment, or a less accurate but still fairly effective method is to actually use the miter gauge itself. If you're going to use the miter gauge to align the fence to the miter slot, you're going to need the miter gauge, and you're going to need a piece of paper, or slightly less accurate, but certainly a lot easier to handle, is a business card. Talking degrees of accuracy here, whilst the piece of paper is more accurate at 3/1000ths of an inch thick, the business card is about 12/1000ths of an inch thick. So less accurate, but it's a lot easier to work with. It's more rigid, it's less flexible, and it's a little bit easier to handle. For what it's worth, I normally use a business card, and I've never had any problems. With your miter gauge in the slot, put your business card beside the miter gauge and slide the fence up to contact. The trick is to relax your fence just enough that you can easily slide the card in and out. Then simply slide the miter gauge to the far end and check again. So that's fine, which isn't really surprising considering that I just set it up with using the dial indicator. The other adjustment that we need to make is the height that the fence sits off the tabletop. What we need is for the gap between the table and the fence to be uniform and as thin as possible for the entire distance. Normally I just set this up by eye, but you could easily cut some thin wooden biscuits to serve as a feeler gauge for setting the gap.
The adjustment points are here and here,
these little plastic set screws. As you can see, this end of the fence is a little bit high, so I need to drop down these set screws so I can lower this end. It's also important to ensure that the fence is level to the table. It doesn't really matter when you're cutting standard stock, like 6x2 or 4x2 using this fence, but if you need to cut chamfers or you need to cut tenons using the table saw, so you put a higher extended fence on here, you will need to check that that is level. And the easiest way to do that is just to use a set square to the table. So, as you can see, we now have a narrow uniform gap between the fence and the table. Table saw alignment is very important, not only for the accuracy of your cuts, but also for operator safety. If the table saw fence is kicked off towards the blade at the back end, it causes a natural pinch point, which causes the back teeth of the blade to engage with the stock and is one of the main causes of kickback. So just remember, accuracy equals safety.